Thank you very much, God bless
you.
Every day,
we pray that God perfects us. Let's confess those things in our lives so that we walk in the Spirit. Hallelujah.
Our spirit
Yes, I'm the one. Because
I'm bringing them.
Yes, I do that.
Then I come
to realize that many times I travel with people that
so you know, brother, as you interact,
or you have a pastor, as you pastor,
yeah, you know, nothing. When I'm talking about you, have you ever seen him?
I don't know what we're going
to
do. So, that's why
you are. You know, you do other funny things when there are people knowing.
So the man traveling, I'm not my name.
When I'm traveling, I know that I'm with someone.
And I behave as such.
I'm not going to be able to do it.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Freewam.
Are we together?
Freewam.
Are we?
I know it has been cold a bit, but see, this is the best weather for preaching.
Let me go in on it.
In Jesus'
name.
So, before I can proceed, let me make these two announcements to add on what has been made. There is a school of ministry that is beginning tomorrow.
I walk and over the south, you know, where they say the plantation?
At Wing of God.
Wing of God.
It is a school of ministry for ministers.
You don't know where it is.
An upcoming minister.
However, as well as the exam.
It is going to handle issues of theology.
Now, what are you going to do with the doctor in the Bible?
Biblical studies.
The doctor in the Bible, you know.
And ministry.
No where it is.
And it's very good for whoever is aspiring to serve God.
And I this time, you know,
it is something that should have been carried out somewhere in the Bible school established somewhere.
Because
many people don't afford to go. We have a friend from the US who is coming to work with us. And he has come up with a program
really
of helping program ministers. We get training,
basically.
And so,
I've
been privileged to be a coordinator of that program.
And we will run about
2 years.
Amen.
So, I know that our friend should be already in the country.
It's
from the US where we are starting. We are admitting, first of all, only male leaders.
Then
we are going to organize training that will capture the female leaders as well. You don't have to be surprised about that. Where I studied at Hope Omega, only men. Ladies don't study there. But we have no problem with that. We come and train our ladies. Okay, so we want those people to be registered with me. Before I leave here, I want to know who is going to work. So, and it will say that.
And we can't keep ourselves.
Amen.
Amen.
You can't have a coordinator of the program.
You cannot coordinate on you when you are in the program.
In the Muzo and Akanatida.
Then you go with the practice.
No.
Then?
Hakunya now. Akanatida, I don't know. Akanatida,
I don't know. So you belong to Siodo.
Even
you mix it in the soup will be black.
So please, take note of that.
Kale, you must take care of something.
Yesterday we should have done some cleaning around. The rain has overtaken us. But I think the rain again failed those who had come to work. And I want to request, especially here, the people who are at on holiday, have enough. And everybody else can come. Clean the place. We work on the ambience of our
great
place.
Amen.
Yes, Pastor, I'm going to bring some runaway moves for us around.
Amen.
I also failed to come. But we promise that next time you come here,
and that's true,
you're going to find a place very clean. Amen. So, those of you can have some time tomorrow. Please let us know that you'll be around. And we work with you. Because from here, we'll be at the of God.
They were living
completely.
So that the water flows from my
hand. Then do the cleaning as far as you can go.
Jesus,
our
Lord.
That is finished.
Come here as you went. Bless Jesus. Why did I see Moses?
Come here as you went.
And he saw you. They don't come up.
I thank God.
Last week, but once
we get it.
I left here. I went to Kampala. There.
So you now in Kampala.
Had some issues that I went to sort.
And then this one again.
I started a small business from there. Because these people came and took everything.
Yeah, that is a business. Yeah, but since he is massive,
so I had no money to pay them. I come back.
I know we are
waiting and look for some money.
And
even the container that I was using was not mine, I was just selling it. But I thank God that I got it back and I gave it to the owner. May God bless you.
Come on, brother. Sir. I tell you, we have forgiven it here. So our things now.
They took some.
Why? They take them. Standards.
We have to do great things.
Amen. And I sent back a 3 younger men, one to Kadenge, another
to Kadenge.
I was part of the coordinators. This is all about today. From CC,
I know there is.
On Friday, I went to Budaka.
You
know, we are working on that mission to Webere. I always want to make sure that there are no loopholes. Mission should be done very well. And I came to learn that normally with issues of public gatherings, you have to consult the security people. To the district police commander, and I copied it to the LOC one of Webere village, and the OC Police post.
No, see police post.
Police station.
The police station.
Things
are really changing in the government.
Police post is a station.
The one who was the police post is now a police station.
Okay. So when I reached Budaka, as I was getting out of the vehicle, I met Pastor Robert Rubunia.
I see Kanon Sumba
Metrapet. Those are the pastors in Budaka district.
Say,
so why are you here? I wrote out my letters. This is why they're writing me here. They were all colored like as you can see. You know what he did? He said, you just now drop this letter head. Go back the
computer
and write the letter fresh.
I
said, how?
Oh.
Write to the resident district commissioner. Hello. The
additional.
To the attention of the DPC.
DPC.
Who will refer you to the OC station?
What OC station?
Say, who told you to make things so messy like that?
So
that's how we do. I don't even know where I come from, there is also Uganda police. And the same government of Uganda wants to fight.
You do know this makes sense.
Kare, it's okay. You know, one time I went to preach in Kaderun and I preached on the subject, I am the voice.
I am the voice.
Then he said, okay, since you are the voice, you can't talk to them. As I was walking from the state past the hospital, I prayed a short prayer. I said, oh God, I want to uproot all encumbrances in this matter.
I
could understand encumbrances.
Yes.
I said, that's the one who gave me that word.
Then I
reached there. Another big officer asked me, yes.
Officer,
how can we help you? I said, I've come to visit the office of the district police commander.
Yeah, DPC.
Okay. Then summon somebody.
You
can have a seat. Outside. To the way.
They just called me.
Remember. Can you please, you can now go in.
I said, oh yeah.
And you come.
I reached.
Please have a seat.
Yeah, okay, I'm going.
Charlie, I want to play popular.
I was there opening my.
He brings out his hands to receive them.
This is outreach.
Outreach.
What?
Okay. So I said, I am the overseer of this work.
Means overseer only.
And we are going to have a serious mission there, so we don't have
it. But means so no man to find.
We don't ask permission from police to preach the gospel. We inform them. We are partners. And I am very careful when I write my letter. This is to register in your office, our intention. To register.
I got a pen.
And we
started writing.
Osi, the Osi was in the next office.
Osi, I've been on your face.
These people have to do their mission. I think they even fill the public order management form. Yes. Oh, make sure that one is done very quick. And then he gave other copy this one. Then I went to her office. She gave me this one. Said, but we don't have any copies. We don't have this one. So I get to need two more. So I got a photocopy. Yes, you can even make some more for us. But it was in less than like 40 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
through so and so.
Who told you that?
Police implements security.
Oh, police.
Can I deal with the big man at the top?
And
he comes with squeezy. Other officer down
there.
They don't know where you are station. It is a count.
It went yesterday.
Nothing here, one of the members of the church that is again to represent the
rule.
What you want to say?
Even the other one give.
Me, Pastor, why are you waiting for copy?
Security is covered.
Now,
security.
You
pray for me.
Tell me office.
Pray for this office.
Remember what I'm doing. I got to
direction
of prayer.
You give me direction of prayer.
In your garden, you need
that. Then I started
to pray.
I pray.
Then
I open the door. I pray. I declare that blessing. I left when you were saying.
Even my number. Let us keep in touch. And it's going to take us to the other side. Amen.
Next one is what?
When I came here, it's in this morning, I saw a littering of sackets of condom, torn condoms. Those sackets. When you tear, then you remove what you want to use it from inside it.
Now, these ones were littered in our compound. These ones.
Some people want to show us that they are so strong. They can use condoms.
So, what's a condom?
And first of all, those things are very cheap. They are free. They even put them on trip, please.
You got to keep.
Now, when I got it, because they said,
you should not have used it
there. You know, I got Nasa said, you see, and your family.
Nasa said, that like, so that they my family. That's what's big.
Cardicino.
Now, this.
They are about against it. Is a one.
I want to show them that I'm a fighter.
Chino chinja kukoma.
This one will end.
Oruareo.
Today.
Munyukira, we ba kora pupu wano mchana.
Remember when they used to come here to poop from here.
Unakwata pupu. Nasinga benches, Nasinga pupu wangu tomkulu. Nakwata kakaro. They used to do that. Pakaro twani ga.
We're good at
it. Why now? We have a child and I'm trying to find someone.
We're praying here. We're
coming. We're coming.
We're coming. You come and we repeat. And
we're coming. Pakaro kuni zigo mbiyo.
You want to listen?
Ola yeye seta solo kuni kulonya.
Shaka
kiondo na kusubiri.
Kiondo
na frequency.
And you will be
the same.
I don't know maybe the one used Greek
or I can tell you again I told you
I told you told
you I told you that you
die one time
nature come out
I never ended
Kationo
now this one here
This
one who can use the package and even show us that.
The
prayer. If you are listening to me whenever you are, on this one. I want to release the bread fighter.
He's called the Lord of Hosts.
Niyo mkama weje.
Amaje, zije, hosts.
Mkama wa maje.
Maje,
hosts.
Katima magendo kusara uche, obatu kolichi.
Now you are the one to decide what you should do.
Obatu joko power.
Oh, we take the power. Do you know that God cannot be mocked?
God cannot be mocked.
Galatians
6. God cannot be mocked. Do you know that God is a man of war? I want to read you one verse and we are going to read it in fire. We are going to release the fire.
But your man
is a man of war. We are going to release the fire. But your man is a man of war.
Last month, the sister came in.
I was sitting in here.
She was sitting like, hey,
what is happening?
What, Chichi?
I'm sorry, but I have to tell you this.
So you want to know?
Every time I go through our time,
it
is just a hell on
earth. You see?
And my sister there is worse.
So it was in the family.
Then I said, it is ending today.
Next month, we're going to chill
out. You know, sick.
Yanko with a sheep.
She called me.
I don't know who it is.
He said, I have this. What have you done? Then he said, when I started this,
no more flow. No pain.
No pain.
Yeah. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
So, Kabaku, when you got a person,
Kabaku.
In Sura, a Yoko Safno, Yoko Minister, Kama katonda kuli yeyeji
and God does gracious things. Abba, what you say? He went out for the salvation of your people, for the salvation of your anointed. You crush the head of the house of the wicked, laying him bare from thigh to neck. You pierced with his own arrow the heads of his warriors, who came like a whirlwind to scatter me, rejoicing as if to devour the poor in secret.
Asomi soma katundu tundu olioko oliokenziremu.
Okay. That is what? It said, you went out for the salvation of your people. For the salvation of your anointed.
Wanunula abantu wo norokola omufukeko wa mafuta wo.
You crushed the head of the house of the wicked.
Wabete yitabo mutwe gwe nyumba eyababi.
Laying him bare from thigh to neck.
No, no, mwambulula okuva ku mutwe paka ku bigere.
You pierced with his own arrows the head of his warriors.
No, okozesa ebirego obusaale bwe wennyini n'obufumita.
Who came like a whirlwind to scatter me?
Eyajjanga empewo yakasini okunsasaanya.
Rejoicing as if to devour the poor and sick.
Kansekera kansekerako. Owulidde. Ha ha! Katonda agenda kubetenta.
God is going to crush.
Omutwe gw'oyo akulembera ennyumba y'omubi.
Head who is running the wicked.
You will crush.
Yeah,
from the head to the top.
Oh, so that
you walk around in to come again and take a young little walk.
Oh, this is going to be this, but going to put fire
in the name of
Jesus' name.
Oh, go ready, Pono.
He has to stretch your hands. I said, stand up.
You are spellbound.
What do you have to
do? You have
to stand. Stand like a soldier. If you have never prayed a good prayer, pray today. I believe that God
has a real physical repudiation, real attack and the punishment.
Okay, that's what I'm saying.
We have a little time.
Sunday, I spoke about missions.
And the other Sunday was talking about
mission. On Easter Sunday, I spoke about the resurrection and our missions mandate.
On Easter Sunday, I talked about the resurrection mandate.
And then last Sunday, I spoke about the triumph of missions.
I said,
what God has ordained for us to do in missions work
is
not going
to be easy.
We are going to meet resistance.
We are going
to find communities that are really opposed to the gospel.
Some places
the leaders will stand against
it. But from the
word of God we found
out that
all over,
wherever
God has called is his
work.
There was always triumph. God always broke through.
And we came
to learn that missions work will always be triumphant.
And
we said, as we work towards the triumph of missions,
these
things are very important. We said prayer is important. Prayer is key for the success of missions. We should be prayerful people. Commit yourself to God. If you are called to serve God,
and
when He leads you to pray, pray seriously. That was number one point I told you. And we must be praying. This year, I made prayer very important in my life. When we were starting this year, the Lord led me to pray for the whole month of January.
And
thank God for our progression.
And
I was ending. I got a conviction that I must punctuate the year with the fire. I said, what does it mean to punctuate the year with
the
fire? And now, every quarter of the year, the first month of the quarter is going to be spent in prayer. So 4 months of this year will be in prayer and fasting.
I've
so far done January and April. All of it. No matter what happens, I am in prayer. And the Lord has given me the grace. I've never seen it. So I'm waiting for the next month of fire. This year we are punctuating it with fire. So when the enemy is entrapping behind you and is coming, he's going to meet fire.
Hey!
Osadangako. We saw that God has got control over all nations, all people groups are under the control of God. In every nation in this world, God has control, so we shall be triumphant wherever we go. We also said all the ends of the earth will remember the Lord and return to worship. They may have forgotten God, but they will come back. We also said that salvation will lead a people movement. Where we have a head of the family giving his heart to Christ, and the whole of his entire family coming with him. Or maybe a community leader, a clan leader, giving his heart to Christ, and they want to bless all the other people to come. That is what happens. That's what we call a people movement. It is
going
to happen. And also say, that Africa will be saved.
Africa will
be saved. And submit to God. That one will happen. Because we saw that in the scriptures. That Egypt will bow. That will worship God. Kush will return. That is Africa.
We
also say, you either go or you send somebody or both. You go and help others go with you. So that one,
It's very important. Because how can they hear unless somebody is preaching to them? How can they preach unless somebody has sent them? So when we can send our missionaries, it's by facilitating them financially. That's why today we have a mission Sunday. The mission Sunday is for you to understand and carry the burden of mission. Not only by words, but through action. Do your giving, supporting the mission, sending people the mission people. As we go out, we are going to need your money, we are going to need your energy, we are going to need everything about you. So you either go or send someone. And also say, missions work or the gospel will be admired or received by the people. People receive the gospel. Don't fear. Nations will hear the gospel and live and get amazed. So let us believe God. Now today, I want to proceed to talk about the triumph of missions. I want to continue on that song. These things are very important. These ideas are important. Point number one today. The gospel message is a declaration of the greatness of God and His marvelous deeds. The gospel message is a simple declaration of the greatness of God and His deeds. Let's see in Psalm 96 and verse 3. My sister sang here a very good song to do with her standing on a mountain and declaring what the Lord has done. I'm going to talk about that very soon. Also. I wonder if she was in the message. It's good to be in the spirit. Yes. So are you there?
Psalm 96:3 says, declare His glory among the nations.
Yes.
His marvelous works among all the people.
Amen. Mm. Declare His glory among the nations. And His marvelous deeds among all people. You see the word declare? It's a proclamation. You speak factual matters. There is no argument about them. Like what we say, Jesus Christ died on the cross and rose again. He's alive. Those are declarations about the gospel truth. We don't have to argue. Nobody should argue. Whoever has a different idea, let him come aside and you educate him all there. But as you stand, declare the truth of God. The Bible says, declare the glory among the nations. We declare the power of God. We declare that there is no one like Him among the nations. What are nations? These are people groups coming from a common descent and speak the same language. They can be Lakwere, they can be Lateso, the Chaka, the Kikuyu. All those are nations. We are going to them and declaring to them that is glorious, that God is powerful, that God loves them, that they should give up their witchcraft, they should give up the demon worship of ancestors, they should give it up. We are going to present a glorious God, a God who can lift them up, a God who can bless them. Our God is a God of glory. But I told us,
our God
is Jubali.
It's not Jubali.
They just bring the new rope.
Siya katonda kwe tuongela Tuongela katonda wa chitiri Tuongela katonda kwa mbula Katonda kuja wa limu masika Akuja kenji suwalo chama jaja wanda wa seka Katonda kwe tuongela Kwe tuwale wile Kwe tuwale mateso Kwe tuwale
baganda
Among the nation. That is mission's work. You must go and declare the glory of God.
You are
the times. Enjoy our seats. And we are busy at all our stores of business. And we are not going in any way. Listen to me, brother. If you can't go, then send somebody. Somebody will go.
Yeah.
When that person goes, because you are putting money, you are putting sound system, you are putting your gate to transport them. Because you are done now, you will have actually gone. So nobody should
I
have too busy enough to go. We will all go in one way or another. Because God tells us, declare His glory. Declare among the nations. We are going to declare, not in one nation, but among nations. In Uganda, we shall finish. We'll go to East Africa. We'll go to all of Africa. We are going to the Americas. We shall go to Europe. We are going everywhere. From here, in Jesus' name.
I think we'll be joking.
We'll look at the service of motors now.
I'm
a spy.
Yes,
I'm a spy.
You are going
to Oyamokumurine.
You are going to preach the gospel.
Otu uke. You are going to marry Unya. Please,
I am not so good at men.
Am I the one here? Amen.
Yeah.
But we must start from where we are. We
looked at the end of it.
Number two. The elevation of God's house.
You may have come up to a nominal in the locus.
Will draw all men to it. The elevation
of
God's house will draw all men. In Isaiah chapter 2 verse 2, the Lord is saying something about His house. His house is His church.
This
is like church.
This is like
church. God is going to elevate this
house.
So that men will just come to give their life to Jesus. Just because of the glory of the house of God. Listen to this.
Oh, it's a king.
It shall be last days. The mountain of the Lord's temple will be established as chief among the mountains. And it will be raised above the hills. And all nations will stream to it.
But we come for you to see. Somebody get me some water.
Bible again.
Biggest things.
When we say the Lord of Anima, or the Son Z, when you may have come, Lulin may say what? Ngolo Kuru, Mun Sos. Lulin, we must see what also Kuru Mun Sos. Era, Namawanga, Gona, Gari Janga, Gai, Yamuluo.
Amen.
I have said that the elevation of God's house will draw all men to eat what is God's house here. That Lord's temple. He comes in the mountain of the Lord's temple. Now there are other mountains. When we talk about mountains in this scripture, it's not meaning these physical mountains. Mountain go, Mount Rizal, Mount Kilimanjaro, Himalayas. No! He's talking about places of authority. Authority can be righteous or wicked.
Oh, we need a solo banner.
You see, that
That's why you can go and invite the whole place from here to there. It is all of shrines. And the whole place is under the control of witchcraft. So the mountain there will be the mountain of witchcraft. Just control it and people. You can go to a place and invite drunkenness. They drink from morning.
Sunset
to morning.
They
don't want to come back again. Is whatever you call it. Sometimes we refer them as altars. But it talks about a power or an authority that controls the people. It controls their mind. It brings them down to do things they don't
love.
God is saying, the mountain of the Lord's temple is going to be established.
Hallelujah.
The mountain of God's temple, the house of God, is going to be raised up as a mountain to have power, to control, to influence villages, cities, nations. That is what the mountains are about. Even when the land is like
Zimbabwean
people, and the government of Uganda takes some of them to
Kiriandongo,
they lived there for a few months and went back. They said,
they refresh the people.
Can say I'm coming to go to
the church of God is blessed at which.
Yes,
When the Quran is falling like a leaf.
What did you call a jar? Are you going to tea, keep or what? That big leaf.
When the Quran is falling,
as the chief among the mountains.
church is going to be strong. Stronger than witchcraft. Stronger than divination. Stronger than the governments of this world.
That
will be perfect. Bring the present
pastor.
Even in the daughter is a pastor. Even in the
pastor
is not a pastor, but a good
one.
People
will
get
said.
The MPs. They will never get said. All of them, they will get said. Where is it? Where
is it?
He brings money.
He brings
money.
God is raising his mountain. The church.
It
now be the chief among the mountain.
Must be chief among the mountain.
Now some of the mountains are good.
So
education is okay.
Also, my
politics is fine. Theater, what is the theatrics? Drama, whatever.
Sports. No sports.
Even education.
Every other mountain.
They are good.
So it's
good. Nayo na.
Order.
God is going to raise us up as a mountain. And people, the Bible says, they will scream, nations will scream. People will come. In Kampala, there was a time when pastors began buying vehicles to ferry people to church. They would just go to church. Others join the bus and then get out along the way to their business. Hey, free transport here. Let me tell you, a number of them are no longer doing it. I think Pastor Kanya no longer does it. But you go there. Go there and see if the people have reduced. They have increased, I don't know how many times. Raise the mountain. Let people see the goodness of God, the wonders of God, the power of God, which is incomparable to any other mountain. People just look for it themselves. I am not against facilitating people for prayer.
What
you want,
if you want,
you must be able to walk.
So
I used to walk over 10 kilometers when I was in
college. When you are just good and said.
At
8
years
already. From
you don't know what you believe.
You
don't know.
God help you from the devil.
witchcraft,
the demons of the clan.
When
he was said, God healed me. I told you that 7 years I will see God the
Lord.
Then you were
saying,
that's
not you
say, you have to search for this issue. So they wanted to bring the drums there. And Jesus healed me. But I don't give
any
information.
I could walk over 10 kilometers
and even now,
I have to go. Is not a and a ticket of Sampa. I don't think
when you have mass on the head, from Lagra,
Nikoa Kaminima,
up to Kaninima.
Then you might distance it,
but do you know that distance?
There are no bananas there. So I will go where there are bananas.
Nikolo,
example to the next of the
data. 4 months if you make
press up when you're blown.
Then the one who the matters will just look for it.
I did that. Number three,
doctor.
There shall be a transformation of lives.
When you bow to your own,
manifesting the knowledge of God. I'm talking about the triumph of missions. You doesn't believe that people will change. I want to tell you today that there shall be a transformation of lives. Manifesting the knowledge of God. Let us look at Isaiah 11 and verse 9. The Bible says something here which is very, very critical. The Bible says, they will neither harm nor destroy on all my holy mountain. For the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea.
They are going to be ashes.
The Bible says they will neither harm nor destroy on all my holy mountain. People are going to be holy here. You are not going to harm here. You are going to do well here. And the earth is going to be filled with the knowledge of God. What does that what mean? Open your eyes. Expand your belief. Don't limit yourself. Which doctors are coming to Jesus? Sheikhs are coming to
Jesus.
Religious people will come. The godless will come. God is saying, all people will have the knowledge of God. This is a super movement of God. It's going to cause a transformation of life. And the people will manifest the knowledge of God. That is why they will no longer harm nor destroy on the holy mountain. My prayer is that this village will have the knowledge of God. So that nobody will think of having or doing anything wrong. That will happen. Let us believe God. Let us pray for the people. Let us go to them.
Let them have the knowledge of God. The knowledge of God will change the people's lives. Amen.
Amen.
Number four. Our perfect Messiah will usher in justice, whose reign will inspire hope to all people. Our perfect Messiah will usher in justice, whose reign will inspire hope to all people. When you look at Isaiah 42 verse 4, the Bible talks about a one person that doesn't falter. He doesn't make any mistake. 42 verse 4. The Bible says, he will not falter or be discouraged till he establishes justice. In his law, the islands will put islands in Zinga.
Zinga
will put their hope in his law. The islands will put their hope. What do we see here? We are speaking about a Messiah, the servant of the Lord, who was to come, and this was Jesus. He came over 2,000 years ago, and now we are here. We are preaching him. He's one that doesn't falter. He's one who does not get discouraged until he establishes justice. We are going to move with the Lord Jesus and his message. And there will be no faltering. There will be no discouragement. We are going to go everywhere until there is justice everywhere. You know that people are suffering from injustice. Sometimes at family level, community level, and national level. Sometimes international level, there's injustice. Let me talk about this. In a household, you've heard what they call domestic violence. People fight over resources as a major issue. And so, you grow rice, and your husband serves the rice, and doesn't bring him a coin at home. As you try to ask, then he says, you, how I don't know. And then the woman is screaming, yes, because of resources. That is injustice. Real, real, real injustice. I want to tell you the truth. Under the suffering injustice, when your politicians come to you and they give you a sacket of salt and a tablet of salt and they ask for your vote, that vote is so powerful, it can counterpart him or her from that village to parliament in parliament. And immediately is given a take of over 200 million. And immediately is given medical allowance. Immediately is given whatever. These pads here, which are very expensive, they are given freely at the cost of a tablet of soap and a sacket of soap. Then you wait for him to come back to do something for you. I don't know about your MP in Paris County. I don't know when I saw him, but I want to tell you the truth. We are waiting. Yeah? Where is another L? We are waiting. At Milam City.
All of you are quiet.
I am talking about injustice. You can't fail to talk about this. Me as a man of the Bible, don't talk about politics. Politics talks about injustice. And there is no better person who can bring justice like Jesus Christ.
Yes.
He will not falter or be discouraged until he establishes justice in the earth. Group maker, you are a politician. He has put up in this group. Since he has been how many times? When they come, they leave their windows, tinted glass windows.
Like
and they meet a few people in Persian gardens and then they fly back. Whether it's this government or in the opposition, and it's not doing the right thing, the work of people, that is injustice. At all, again, I feel Sabah Kassi, I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier.
I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier.
I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a
soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm
a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a
soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a
soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. I'm a
the one who gives you, who give the vote, will be the one who can gather you.
I'm lifting from your levels of poverty.
Man.
Mukama yeva siwe. Alamu kumwe, muli ya nyu, muli ya alese nku, nalese, nalese, nalese,
nalese, nalese, nalese, nalese,
akabaga kakaru mwogo, wali nalese,
nalese, nalese, bring a bag of cassava,
and the three tank of water,
the water, in the room there.
And he said, our man, I don't know if you are standing like this. You are at this.
Yes, because of a few delicate
things.
Yes, of
the property. If you can't even collect water, you want a politician, they will control you. Who is going around with jerrycans of water?
Why?
Why? Because there is always a sign to show change. When it is a womb, you see a scar. What are you talking about? Do something that will cause transformation in
the
people.
Politicians,
injustice must end. Okay. Now the Bible says, all the islands are going to hope in God's law. Can you imagine the islands in Lake Victoria? They are going to hear the gospel. Already the churches are there. But you must know, God is telling us to go to the islands and take their God's law. How will they hear about it unless we take it there? Missions will take you even to the islands. Some of you fear water. Tell your neighbor, God has not given us a spirit of fear. Power, love, and sound mind.
Now,
so don't fear water. God has the people who are living there on the island. We are going to go there also. In Jesus' name. Amen. We are going everywhere. The Bible says they will hope in God's
goodness.
When we go there, they look like they are opposed. In the name of Jesus, so I don't want to say it, but all the islands will hope in your
Lord.
So we shall pray. And God will convert
them.
Amen.
Or
five.
Chapter.
God is everlasting kingdom. Will triumph over all the kingdoms of the
nations.
God is everlasting kingdom.
Will
triumph over. Amen.
Amen.
Look at Daniel chapter 2, verse 44.
Daniel 2:44.
The Bible says,
Bible cover.
In the time of those kings, the God of heaven will set up a kingdom that will never be destroyed, nor will it be left to another people. It will crush all those kingdoms and bring them to an end. But it will itself endure forever. Hallelujah! You get time and read the whole chapter. King Nebuchadnezzar got a dream of an idol. The head was of gold, the chest of something else of bronze, and then like iron, the head of the
So he didn't know what to make. Until
Daniel
told him that this has to do with pignons. He said, you are pig. You are that head of gold. The Babylonian Empire was so great. It ran from all India and it ran over to Africa. Ethiopia was part of Ethiopia. It was a very powerful kingdom. But came to an end.
Hey, come make this.
Hello. You did what?
You're going to
And it was followed by the Persian Empire. The Roman Empire came to an end. This kingdom that the kings is talking about. He goes, in those days of those kings, God will set up his kingdom. It will triumph over all those kings. It will destroy all of them, but itself will not be destroyed. This kingdom is already here. Jesus came and said, repent, for the kingdom of God has come. Did he say, will come?
He
has come. Let me say, the kingdom of God does not come as you see. The kingdom of God is already in you. And he said, when you see me cast out devils, when you see me raise the dead, then know that the kingdom of God has come upon you. That's what God can do. That's what the kingdom can do. So the kingdom came. And you know what? All these other kingdoms are going. Even governments of nations are going to come to an end. But the kingdom of our Lord Jesus Christ will never come to an end. And we must proclaim it. We are taking it all. All over the nation, the kingdom must go. Let us take the kingdom to be ready. Let's take the kingdom to Sorocha, to Karamocha, to Kenya. Let's go. Let's go wherever God says he must have his kingdom. All over the world, the kingdoms of men are going to end. But the kingdom of God will continue forever. But we must go and proclaim that people can be part of it. Lastly, we expect a universal honor of God's name. The universal honor. Who said to you, hey, you know, you have a chance to see your name. Now, I want to go to the same age to
you. Wherever you go, you see people honoring God.
Malachi chapter 1 and verse 11.
Malachi 1 and 11.
The Bible says something very, very, very important here. If you're there, you can read.
1:11.
It said, for from the rising of the sun to its setting, my name will be great among the nations. And in every place, incense will be offered to my name and a pure offering. For my name will be great among the nations, says the Lord of hosts.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Kubanga okubendiwa jeva, okutusa jegwa, erinya lyange kulu mubama wanga. Era obubane buweerwayo mu buli kifo eri erinya lyange. N'ekiweerwayo ekirongoofu. Kubanga erinya lyange kulu mubama wanga, bwayogera Mukama ow'eggye. That is how this one says. He speaks as if it is already. But in Luganda is a little different. I mean in English. In English it says, I want to bring that up clear. It says, my name will be great. Do you see that?
We
it's not already great. There are people who still don't think they believe in Jesus. There are people who abuse God's name. It's not great among them.
But the Bible says, my name will be great among the nations. From the rising of the sun, the rising to the setting of the sun, in every place, incense and a pure offering will be brought to my name, because my name will be great among the nations, says the Lord Almighty. This text in the English version is speaking about a future
sermon.
By the time it was written, and it has started happening, because Abraham, I am praising my God. I am saying God is great, God is powerful, and you are part of that as well. Some of you, all your family is saying God is great, all your family. Now there are places you go, and this family is saying it. This one is saying, the other is saying, the other is saying, and it's like they call it Chirokole Zone. Have you ever heard of that?
Chirokole Zone.
Now, almost everybody there, but in my Mukama wa Amai,
God is great.
That's
what we want to be.
Mukama Agami,
the Lord has
said,
man,
be great for my Wanga.
Among the nation.
I got that in my Wanga.
I said, the nation. That's the nation. If you are
we want to do it
symbolically
and declare that our nations from which we come must declare the name of God is great. And you know what? Incense will be brought. Incense represents prayer. That means our people are going to come to God and pray. They will pray to Him, they will worship us.
Don't mind.
Bali Munsansi, Bali Muniseke, Banyamanwa, Exera Kituki, Bata and Goku in Edoka.
They will come back to the Lord and they will worship Him.
Then He said, pure offerings will be brought.
Amen.
They are going to offer to God, beginning with their lives. Their lives will be pure. And then when they bring offerings, they will be perfect gifts from their hearts. Sacrificial gifts. Today, we are going to give a mission offering. I want you to check your life. As you come, is your offering pure? Is it a perfect offering? Is it something really commensurate with your income? Something that you can give, or you could have given more? Is there a malice in your giving? God is saying His name will be greater than this. Incense will be brought. And offerings pure. I want to speak to you watching me. That God knows you. Doesn't matter what nation you are, what your people are, but God knows them. Before your people group came to be, God knew it and blessed it where you are. Your people belong to God. Believe God that your people, together with you, will declare the glory of God. And they'll pray to Him. They'll bring the incense, whether the prayers of the saints. They'll bring pure offerings without malice. They'll give generously in support of the mission's work. Because we're talking about winning the whole world to our God. Because our God must be the King.
I know, but
your kings, King of the nations. God bless you. In the name of Jesus. Now listen to me, friends. I want us to believe God that the gospel message will be shared simply as a declaration. And people will take it. And God's house will be elevated. And there will be a transformation of lives. The Messiah, Jesus Christ, will not falter, will not make any mistake until justice reigns everywhere. And the people will hope in Him everywhere we go. We believe that God is everlasting kingdom. We triumph over all the kingdoms, over all the governments of nations. And friends, Let God come a universal honor to the name of our God. Coming from all people that He has created. Shall we pray? Father, in Jesus' name, I give you praise. I worship you because you're so awesome. We are sharing about the missions. And we know that the mission and this work that you've started will continue bearing fruit until it is done. I pray today that you bless us as a church, as a ministry, that we'll be able to emphasize missions like we emphasize other purposes of the church, and that we'll go out and win the world to you, and we shall give our lives, our resources, and bring the gospel to the people that deserve it. Thank you so much. Bless your people as we give today for the missions work in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Now,
but
before we get, you could be here in your seat.
Why?
The Lord said, His house will be exalted.
Then all men
will squeal and do it.
You
can't heal the sick when you are sick. You must be healed.
So
that you can go.
That's what we must
want. Take healing
for others.
Stand up. Those who are sick, we're going to pray for you. Can you stand up, please? Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. How many of you say, I am blessed? I am something about mission.
Hallelujah.
Give him a big hand clap. Put those hands up in the air. Is there somebody that you see?
Put up your hand.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, touch what you have been praying. We are very serious. God answers prayer. God
answers prayer.
Healing is for today. Some people teach you that healing ended. The day of miracles is gone. How can the day of miracles go? When the God of miracles is still there. God is there. And he still does his work. He blesses his people. He still heals them. So let's pray for him. Father Jesus is
there.
I pray for those people whose hands are lifted up. They have various pains, various troubles. I pray for them. That your hand touches them now. Let that pain die in Jesus.
Yes.
Let that pain in the bones,
yes,
in the flesh, in the nerves, in the name of Jesus. I rebuke that pain in the neck, in the head, in the uterus, in the fallopian tubes. I rebuke it now. I command it to die in Jesus' name. Father, let that be healing. Let there be healing upon your people. Let there be healing in the name of Jesus. Let them, let your people be lifted up. That they will not be down in sickness. Let those who see the God of miracles, the God of wonders, the God of power working for your people so that they will also believe in you. Father, I thank you because it is done. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. So let us thank God for that healing. You may be seated as a worker. You take us to our very major idea we've been planning for the mission Sunday. I think for Sunday.